Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss about the Mughal Empire, Akbar, Akbar's conquest and Akbar's administration. Humayun did not live long to consolidate his power. In 1556, Humayun died from a fall from his library building in Purana Qila at Delhi. Akbar was only 13 years of age when he was proclaimed the Emperor of India. It was a difficult position for the empire. The Afghan chiefs were still in occupation of the greater portion of the Sher Shah's dominions. However, Bairam Khan, Akbar's tutor and his father's trusted officer, rose to the occasion. Bairam Khan became the regent and looked after the kingdom until 1560. Second Battle of Panipat. Soon after Akbar's accession, Hemu, a nephew of Sher Shah Suri, captured Agra and was on the march to Delhi. The Mughal forces met Hemu's army on the historic battlefield of Panipat in November 1556. After a fierce battle, the Afghan army was defeated and Hemu was captured and killed. That was the end of the Afghan resistance to the Mughals. Akbar's Mansabdari system, revenue reforms and policy of religious pacification. Akbar created an imperial service based on merit and graded according to military rank. It was called Mansabdari system. The lowest rank was that of 10, whereas the highest was 5,000 for the nobles. The princes received higher mansabs, the rank of 7,000 each. The mansabdars held their appointments directly from the emperor. Land revenue system. Land revenue reforms were introduced in 1580 when Todarmal became the Diwani Ashraf. It means head of the land revenue department. Todarmal devised a system based on a survey and measurement of land, classification of land according to its productive capacity, and fixation of rates payable in cash or kind by the cultivators. Akbar regarded speedy administration of justice as one of his important duties. The chief qazi was the foremost judicial officer in the realm. Akbar's racial and religious pacification. Akbar sought to bring out racial and religious pacification in the country. The jizya, or the poll tax on the non-Muslim, was abolished. State service were opened for the Hindus. The emperor patronized Hindu writers and artists. He had matrimonial alliances with the Rajput families. In 1580, the emperor promulgated a new cult called Din Ilahi. It was based on the belief that there is only one God and required its member to accept virtues such as courage, chastity and justice. It also demanded loyalty to the emperor. The new cult could not have many followers and it was never imposed on people. Mughal administration. The administrative system of the Mughals was partly designed on the pattern of Persian and Egyptian monarchs and partly based on Indian traditions. The administration was mainly the work of Akbar. The administrative machinery developed by Akbar that was maintained under Jahangir and Shah Jahan. So students, in this video, we discussed about Akbar and his conquest, Akbar's administration, Mansabdari system, revenue system and religious policies of Akbar. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.